Not really, you know, we're not really the founding fathers we used to be.
Yeah. It's fine, you know, in a little bit, people will start making a musical about us.
Maybe we should do that right
Maybe
now.
Maybe we should make a musical.
About us.
About us.
How does a bastard orphan son of a whore and a Scotsman dropped in the middle of a forgotten spot in the Caribbean by Providence, impoverished and squalor, somehow grow up to be a hero and a scholar? The $10 founding father without a father got a lot farther by working a lot harder, by being a lot smarter, by being self-starter by 14, that placed him in charge of a trading charter. And every day while slaves were being slaughtered and carted away across the waves, he struggled to help his guard up inside. The brother was longing for something to be a part of. The brother was ready to beg, steal, borrow, or barter. And a hurricane came and devastation rained. Our man saw his future dripping down the drain. Put a pencil to his temple, connected to his brain, and he wrote his first refrain, a testament to his pain. While the world got around, they said, this kid is insane, man. Took up a collection just to send him to the mainland. Get your education, don't forget from whence you came. The world's gonna know your name. What's your name, man? It's Fundy.
I am Hercules, motherfucker!
Why did you start filming on the sexual bit?
I don't know!
It's been a virus, bro.
Wrong. Nothing rich folk love more than going downtown and slumming it with the poor. They walk up in the carriages and gawk at the students in the common just to watch them talk. Take Philip Schuyler, the man is loaded. Uh-oh, but little does he know that his daughters, Peggy, Angelica, Eliza, sneak into the city just to watch all the guys.
Walk.
Angelica!
Walk.
And Peggy.
Peggy.
What?
He said to be home by sundown.
Wait,
Chad.
Who are you?
Why do I know who says what? Like I said, you're free to go.
Look around. The revolution's happening in New York. Work.
Shit.
It's bad enough that he wants to go to war.
People shouting in the square.
It's bad enough that we violence at our shore.
New ideas are in the air. Look around, look and fuck!
Angelica, remind me what we're looking for.
Liza's looking for a mind at work. Looking for a mind at work. I'm looking for a mind at work. Whoa, work.
There's nothing like summer in the city. Someone in a rush, someone looking pretty. Excuse me, miss. I know it's not funny, but your perfume smells like your daddy's got money. What you slumming in the city in your fancy heels? You searching for a nutrient that can give you ideals?
Bro, you disgust me.
So you disgust me. I'm a trust fund baby. You can trust me.
Work or reading. Shit, I don't know this part.
Work or reading.
I don't know. Lucian, I want a revelation, so listen to my declaration. Behold this truth to be self-evident, but I'm not created equal. And when I meet Thomas Jefferson, I'm compelled to include women in the sequel. Work!
Look around, how lucky we are to be alive right now. I'm behind.
Look around, how lucky we are to be alive right now.
It's the real top in the advanced top
in the greatest city in the world.
Because I've been reading Thomas Hazard Thomas Paine.
The revolution is happening in New York.
You want a revolution? I want a revelation.
Look around. How lucky we are to be alive right now.
History is happening in Manhattan.
We just need to be the greatest city in the world. In the greatest city in the world. Angelica!
Eliza!
Hey!
I'm looking for my
mind at work.
Hey!
Oh. In the greatest city, in the greatest city in the world!
Wow.
Jesus!
That was beautiful.
Oh, we're going down.
Can I be real a second? For just a millisecond? Open my mouth and tell the people what I feel a second.
Yes.
Yeah, whatever. It was a Hamilton song. You didn't get it.
After the war, we went back to New York. Now you go.
Tommy Hanberg is being cooked.
I finished my practice and I practiced law. I practiced law. Wilbur. Worked next door. Even though he... You're not joining in.
Even though we started at the very same time, Tommy Innit began to climb. How to account for his rise to the top? Man, the man is non-stop.
Gentlemen of the jury, I'm curious. Bear with me. Are you aware that we're making history? This is the first murder trial of our brand new nation. Her liberty behind the liberation. I'm going to start without a counsel in doubt and a pro counsel hammer. There you go. Tommy Innit, sit down. Say, you will. We studied and we killed. For the notion of a nation, we now get to build.
We're trying to fucking build it!
And with pride. I don't understand why you... Look at you. Stood to the side.
Daddy, daddy, look.
My name is Fundy. I am a poet. I wrote this rhyme just to show it. And I just turned 9. You can write rhymes, but you can't write mine. I practice French and play piano with my mother. I have a sister, but I want a little brother. My daddy's trying to start Le Manburg under toi. Tommy's a jerk!
Large am I? Wait, stand
in the
my
eye
threshold.
Of the hurricane,
my,
there is
sh-
quiet for just a moment.
Wait.
The election of 1800.
Every action has an equal opposite reaction. John Adams shat the bed. I love the guy, but he's in traction. Poor Alexander Hamilton, he is missing in action. So now I'm facing Aaron Burr with his own faction.
He's not all very attractive in the north. You knew it was like
his stand. He's not coming on any particular stances.
Ask him a question. It glances off his obstructions.
As
he dances.
I'm a Francophile. At least I say I know where France is.
Thomas, the problem is they see Burr as a less extreme.
Huh?
You. You need to change course. A kind of
you have in mind?
I don't laugh.
Who is it?
You used to work on the same stuff.
What?
It might be nice. It might be nice to get Hamilton on your side.
It might be nice. It might be nice to
get
Hamilton on your side.
Talk less. Smile more. Don't let them know what you're against or what you're for. Shake hands with him. Charm her. It's 1800, ladies. Tell your husband. Vote for Burr.
I don't like Adams.
Well, he's gonna lose. That's just defeatist.
And Jefferson.
Enough with friends.
He's so elitist.
I like that Aaron Burr.
I can't believe we're here with him.
He seems approachable.
Like, you could grab a beer with him.
Tubbo?
Oh, dear, Mr. Hamilton, your fellow friend. Like,
quiet uptown.
Dear Mr. Hamilton. Joel Adams doesn't stand a chance, so you were here to promoting whatever.
Quiet uptown.
Aaron or Burr.
We know it's lose.
Jefferson or Burr. But
if you have to choose,
dear Mr. Hamilton,
Jefferson or Burr.
That's a chance. Who will you be promoting? But if you had
to choose. If it isn't Aaron Burr, sir.
Alexander.
You've created quite a stir, sir.
I'm going door to door.
You're openly campaigning.
Sure.
That's new.
Honestly, it's kind of draining.
Is there anything you wouldn't do?
No, I'm chasing what I want, and you know what? I learned it that from you. If you had to choose, it's a tie.
If you had to choose, it's up to the delegates.
If you had to choose, it's up to
Hamilton. Jefferson or Burr.
If you had to choose.
Yow. The people hear my voice.
Oh!
The country is listening to my story.
Oh!
You were asking who I promote.
Oh!
Jefferson has my vote.
Oh!
I have never agreed with Jefferson one.
Oh!
All my 7 projects have done.
Oh!
When all is said and all is done, Jefferson has beliefs. Burr has none.
Ooh, well, I'll be damned. Hamilton's on your side.
Well, I'll be damned. And?
You won by a landslide. Oh, congrats on the race, well won! I did give you a fight! Looking forward to our partnership.
Our partnership?
As your vice president?
Yeah, right. You hear this guy? Man openly campaigns against me talking about I look forward to our partnership.
That's crazy. The guy who comes in second gets to be vice president?
Oh, you know what? We can change that. You know why?
Why?
Because I'm the president. Hey, Burr, when you see Hamilton, thank him for the endorsement.
I'm sorry. I just forgot what was going on halfway through.
We did that so badly.
Can we start another song or something?
Oh, wait,
how does Hamilton?
Oh no. Oh, no.